developing a child-friendly learning space.
Miss Evua! Miss Evua!
Hello! Hello, Kami. Hello, Zobi.
Hello.
Hi, Miss Efwa. Wow, look at all of these beautiful decorations. Is there a party going on at school today?
A party? Will there be a dancing here? Mm-hmm. Will there be singing? Miss Efwa, will there be games?
Well, there'll be dancing, there'll be singing, and there'll even be games. But it's not a party. It's a school. This is where I teach.
That's not possible. No ways, eh? And where are the pupils, eh? Are they hiding somewhere? Hello, pupils! Hello!
Well, they're not yet here. I'm just setting up.
So this really is a school. It looks so colorful and so much fun.
Good. That's what I was hoping. When my pupils arrive, I want them to feel excited and welcome. Kami, how do you feel when you look around my teaching space?
I feel like I can't wait to learn.
Yo. Like Miss Eva, what's in this box? And what will happen over there? Miss Eva, and what's this list? Are these all the things you're going to do today?
Those are great questions, Zobi. I hope my pupils are just as curious as you are. Because the more curious they are, the more excited they'll be to learn. Let me show you around.
Okay. Go.
We're about to see four ways to develop a child-friendly learning space. First, you can set up your classroom in a child-friendly way. Second, encourage your pupils to try learning in different ways. Third, give your pupils a chance to explore. And fourth, make sure every pupil has opportunities to contribute. In a child-friendly classroom, you must help your pupils feel welcome. Your classroom must be safe and feel comfortable. You can achieve this through the way you set up your classroom and the way you interact with pupils. Arrange your chairs or mats in a way that everyone can make eye contact with each other, so everyone will feel included. By putting up a daily timetable, you let everyone know what the routine will be. Your pupils will feel at ease because they know what is coming next. And don't stop there. This teacher has an area where her pupils can hang their own creations. And she's created many different learning environments so that each child can work according to his or her preferred learning style.
Remember a few minutes ago, I told you all that we're going to come here and we're going to talk about our five senses.
When your pupils are comfortable, they will share their interests, ideas, and questions.
Yes?
Excuse me, what are we going to have after this lesson?
Also take time to answer questions. It helps you address the needs of each pupil, and it shows everyone that you care about their thoughts and ideas.
So I've got two boxes in front of me here, and I want you to guess what is inside. Turn and face your partner. I want you to discuss what. Guess, talk.
Let's shake it.
Can I have you facing me again? Are you closer to an idea of what's inside here?
Yes.
Make sure you give every pupil a chance to join in. Okay. This teacher always wastes a few moments when looking for someone to answer a question. This way, a child with less confidence will have a chance to answer.
What else can you do? Yes?
We can smell it.
You can smell it. So come and show me what you...
Ask lots of questions and give your pupils the chance to explore. Rather than worrying about right and wrong answers, let each child develop new ideas, come up with questions, and express his or herself.
What do you think is inside here? Okay, brilliant. So now it's time for us to find out what's inside our boxes. Now, who wants to help to reveal the first one? And can you come and show us what's inside this box?
Tomato!
Say it again.
Tomato!
Tomato!
In a child-centered classroom, the lessons can be exciting and fun. The more pupils are interested, the more they will take charge of their own learning. So remember, to create a child-centered classroom, you must first help your pupils feel safe and comfortable. Help everyone feel included by arranging mats or chairs to allow for eye contact, answering every question, and putting pupils' art around the room. Post the timetable so pupils understand what is happening and feel in control. All of this will help pupils feel at home and ready to contribute. You will have many different types of pupils who learn best in different ways. Working as a whole group, in groups of four or five, or as individuals are all ways pupils can learn.
Okay, pass it to the next person.
When learning is an act of discovery, pupils get excited about the lesson, encourage them to wonder and try out their ideas. Every pupil has something unique to contribute. Be sure that each pupil's voice has a chance to be heard. The more you ask questions, the more you will learn what your pupils know and want to know. Every day you can make discoveries about your pupils, and each discovery will make your job easier, more exciting, and more enjoyable.
So I've got
Wow, Miss Efwa, I think your pupils must have a lot of fun while they learn.
Well, they have a lot of fun, and I have a lot of fun too. In fact, I'm very lucky to be a teacher.
Sure. Miss Efwa, is that what every day is like in your classroom?
Well, every day I try to create an environment that is creative and fun and a place where my pupils want to learn. Oh. But every day is different too.
Why is every day different?
Well, I always carefully plan what my lessons will be. And part of that planning is to make sure that there are times and places where my pupils can contribute. That kind of planning allows my pupils to share their interests. And then I include some of their interests in my lessons.
Wow.
It makes learning special for my class.
Oh, Miss Efwa, I am planning too. I am planning to become a teacher.
Really?
Wow, that's great, Zobi.
Yeah.
It requires some preparation, though. What do you think you should do first?
First, I should get a haircut. Yeah, and buy a new hat. I don't have a pointer. Miss Efwa, can I borrow some chalk?
Sure.
I've got so much to plan for. Guys, I've got to run. Hey, I'm going to be a teacher. Yes! Mm-hmm.